hello, everybody, and thank you for watching the Positive Talk Hour. I am pretty excited about having my new friend on. We have been getting to know each other over, I guess, right about a month now. I met him at a conference with our mutual friend, Dr. Percy, about, I guess, a month ago at the Life Center of Tampa Bay. He is a holistic nutritionist and owns a company called Boomers. I'm going to have him talk a little bit more about that here in a second. But please welcome to the show, Bob Gilpatrick. Hi, Bob. How are you?
Great, Jeremy. Thanks so much. It's really great to be coming on to the podcast. And it's been great getting to know you as a new friend. So I'm very happy to be here.
Welcome to the show, and we're going to be talking a lot about today, and I'm pretty excited about this. We're going to be talking about energy and vitality. Of course, you guys know that that covers that can be a kind of a broad spectrum. We're going to kind of bring it in here and have a good discussion over the next amount of time here on the Positive Talk Hour, you know, Bob is an expert in this area, so I'm pretty excited about that as well. So tell us about, you know, I just kind of want to start off maybe just really shortly. Could you talk about, you know, what you do and, you know, your company briefly, you know, and just tell us how you got to where you're at right now. Maybe a little bit about your partner, your business partner and stuff.
Yeah, sure. Sure. Well, our company is called Boomers Forever Young, and we're an anti-aging, holistic health company. So we have anti-aging holistic nutrition products. And we also teach therapeutic techniques for people to reduce stress and eliminate thoughts and beliefs that can contribute to aging. And about 6 years ago, I met Larry Dodlin here in St. Petersburg, and I came to Larry's office to help him with a computer project. And Larry was what we call crumbly, as the Brits say. He was 65 years old, but his body was functioning more like an 80-year-old. And as I was helping Larry with his real estate business and his computer projects, I started to help him with his health, because for many years I've been a holistic health therapist, and it's just my natural tendency to ask someone, would you like help with this or help with that? And as I started piecing together a regime for Larry to follow, because he was interested in getting better, he began pretty quickly to reduce his weight, to release weight that he wanted to get rid of, and to build strength. And after about maybe 2 or 3 months went by, he had lost 30 pounds of body fat and had doubled his strength working out at the gym. And we had gotten him off of most of his medications. He was on 11 medications when I first met him. And within 6 months, he was off the rest of those medications, and we were able to cancel the surgeries that he was scheduled for. And he transformed from a very old 65-year-old to now going to be 72 years old on his next birthday. And when he went for his last blood test, his life insurance agent called him and he said, I've got some good news for you, Larry. You received superior preferred status for your life insurance policy. You can pay the lowest premium that's available to anyone. He said, it's funny though, the insurance company called me and said, there seems to be a mistake on the application. This man's blood work looks like he's about 30 to 33 years old, but it shows that he was born in 1945. Oh, wow. And wondering if you might correct the date of birth on the application. And so Stuart informed the insurance company, no, in fact, this is a 70-year-old man, and that's his real blood work. And so that's the type of thing that can happen for people. In this new day and age of scientific advancement in nutrition and energy management. And that happened for Larry. And he then started discussing with me the possibility of having a business that would run right out of the same office where I'm sitting now, is the office I came to help Larry with his computer project, and begin to offer the types of interventions that I had helped him with to more people. So we've been doing this for 6 years now, and we have helped thousands of people, it turns out, many thousands, that have found us through podcasts and radio shows and the internet and word of mouth. And we've been able to help many people just like Larry to also de-age, to get off their medications, and to get their life and their energy back. And that's how we started out. And my background was going all the way back to when I was 20 years old. When I was going to college, I first started working as an educator and a social worker. And I went through into my mid-20s, where I was working full-time as a therapist and social worker. Then I went back to school to get my master's degree, which I did, and became then an administrator of social welfare nonprofit organizations, including nursing homes, which I was an administrator of nursing homes for many years. And all during that time, I continued my studies in holistic health therapy. I went to school for neurolinguistic programming, went to school for heart-centered therapy and nutrition and many other types of therapies where I continued my education. And then off and on, I worked part-time or full-time as a therapist at different clinics and doing my own private counseling, and continued it until this day, which is now, I'd say, about 35 years is about how long I've been doing this now.
Wow. Very cool. Thank you for telling us. And I just wanted to throw that out there, as well, before we get started in our discussion, that Bob's company website is www.boomerboost.com. And if you go to their website and you tell them, use the code, promotion code SoulTalk, or if you even call into 800-861-4609 and tell them that SoulTalk or Jeremy McDonald referred you, that'll get you opened up to the promotions for their site as well. So just kind of throw that out there that you guys can check out and benefit from Bob's company and his products and the story you just talked about. So thank you, Bob. So talking about energy and vitality, it's funny, we were just talking about before we started the show, is that a lot of people come up to me and they're like, of course they go in these, they work a 40-hour-a-week job, they're super busy. You know, there's a lot of things just happening in their life. They've got kids, they've got soccer practice, whatever they've got to go to. They're exhausted when they leave, and these aren't just working parents that I talk to. It's and just normal everyday people, and then people that even people in the college age that are saying, I'm just completely exhausted. How do I improve my energy level, and how do I even give them the longevity of my life and stuff like that. So I guess what I would ask you first is, what are some of the external and internal sources that cause lack of energy or vitality with people? Mm-hmm.
Well, Jeremy, this is the number one issue that we hear from people that come to our office or call to our office. And a close second is people that want to lose weight, and they kind of go hand in hand. But some of the reasons why people have so much trouble for energy. Number one is, we live in a very, very busy world now. There are a lot of demands and challenges now and that didn't used to be in, 100 years ago. There were only a few different types of careers that people would have, and a lot of people worked in agriculture. Nowadays, there's cell phones and computers and people working two or three jobs. The industry they're in goes out of business completely, and they have to start a new career. And there's just a lot of stress from that type of a lifestyle. There's also a lot more toxins in the world now than there used to be. There's tire dust everywhere from wherever you live. You can't really escape it. There's pollution that's coming off of the roads. It rises up into the air and cascades down everywhere, gets into people's lungs and eyes and skin. And other air pollutants just from the automobiles themselves, the automobile exhaust, also from our food and water. you also have toxins. And people have a toxic load that they didn't ever have before. Internally, inside your home, you have formaldehyde that's in your curtains, that's in your furniture, et cetera, et cetera. You also have very poor air quality in most homes and businesses. And so even if you come in from the outside to escape tire dust and fumes, quite often the indoor air quality is worse than the air outside. And so it puts a toxic stress onto our bodies. And the other main thing is malnourishment. People in this day and age are eating food that has been grown in soil that's been long since depleted. And even if you eat really good organic food, it doesn't mean that it was really grown in soil that was as healthy as the soil from 100 years ago. And for the most part, most people are not eating organic food. Most people are shopping at their regular grocery store, and the food has almost no nutritional value whatsoever. The other thing that occurs is as people age, many parts of their body systems diminish, including one very important one, which is absorption of nutrition. People absorb most of their nutrients in their small intestine villi. And those villi is what absorbs your nutrition. And if you begin to age, and those villi will get coated over with a plaque. And the plaque was at one time mucus that's naturally occurring in your small intestine, but it'll turn to a plaque as you age. You'll smother the villi, and now you can only absorb nutrients at maybe 15% of the rate that you could when you were younger. Also, typical diets, especially in America, are very high in carbohydrates, in high glycemic index carbohydrates, and there's a diabetes epidemic, which definitely saps people's energy. Another one, because of busy schedules and people living in cities, is a lack of sleep. It's very difficult to balance your light and dark exposure, and the lack of sleep can make a really negative contribution to your ability to have enough energy for the day. Then lastly is the whole emotional and spiritual aspect of people having time and having the opportunity to really be on their life path and really live out their life path that they were born and destined to do. Many people are working in jobs that they don't really like. Only about 17% of the people in the United States are working in a job that they really enjoy and appreciate and are engaged in. And all of the rest of the people are doing things that they don't really want to do. And that's a whole nother matter as to how that saps your energy.
So I wanted to back up real quick because you started, the internet broke up just a little bit. You were talking about the small intestines, I believe, and that were, and you said that, and then really when you came back in, you were talking about we were only absorbing about 15% of our the nutrition from the food, and I thought they were related, but it broke up just for a second.
That's right. In small intestine are these little hairs called villi, which absorb your nutrients from your food and your nutritional supplements. And as you age, a plaque forms in your intestines, and it smothers the villi, and they die off. And so you can only absorb about 15% of the amount of nutrients you could, say, when you were 20 years old.
Gotcha.
That leads to malnutrition, even if you're eating really good food. So you have to have a technique and a technology to revivitize those villi.
Gotcha. Okay, so basically if you have the technology, can revitalize it and help you get that energy back and be more vital in your body.
Yes.
Gotcha. Okay, so it's interesting because you talked about not only sleep and health, and you talked about a couple things, or several things here, and some physical conditions that cause us have lack of energy. And then we went into the spiritual aspect. And I think that's super important too, because, you mentioned how many people are not working and doing what they want to do, or spiritually what they feel pushed to do. Maybe they have a spiritual path that they're not on, whatever that looks like, and whatever makes them feel complete, or what they call it, at the end of the day. And I imagine that probably sucks people's energy out as well.
Yes. There's something, Jeremy, that we do to help people with that. And there are a lot of different exercises that people can do to begin to discover their life path. But on one of the things that people can learn to do is a bioenergetic exercise that we call the ultimate mind calming exercise. And that exercise is very beneficial for many different things, but it can set up a situation where you can create a very quiet meditative state where you can begin to discover what your life path is. And so if you are able to quiet your mind with this exercise, which only takes about 5 minutes, and it will make it so that you go into a state of no mind. And quite often it takes years of meditation or practice to find that state, so you can hear the voice of your higher self, of spirit. But this technique, which you can watch and learn for free on boomerboost.com, it's on the video section, it's called the ultimate mind calming exercise. And once you do that, your brain will go into a state of no mind. And then you can specifically ask questions about your life path and why you're here and what your true purpose is here during this lifetime. And that's a beginning place where you can start to hear the voice of your higher self, the voice of spirit, guiding you and directing you toward what your true life path is.
Kind of goes back to you, it kind of gets you into that still mind so that you can start hearing that inner dialogue and help you, guide you on that path. Because how many people come to a coach or an intuitive and they're not sure what to do? They're just really confused. And so, but what I'm hearing you say, it's multifold. It's such kind of a trifold. It's physical, it's spiritual, it's emotional, and that's more than just one thing. We have to get in balance with all things.
Yeah, and it's tough when you are in a job that is, you're one of those 83% of people that don't enjoy what you're doing. You're doing it just because it's a job. And it causes people to become exhausted, going day after day to the same place they don't necessarily really want to be. And people very commonly get depressed if they're in a situation like that. And once you start to get depressed because you don't have this optimistic, great reason to get up in the morning, then you're going to begin to participate in avoidance strategies that will help you avoid the negative emotions that are associated with not being on path. And they take the form of alcohol and drugs and overeating. And as that occurs, then also your relationships will begin to suffer, because as you make your way home after work, whoever you're with is going to be dealing with a person who's bringing home all of this discordant energy from having just spent the whole day in a situation that they didn't really want to be in. And this ends up making it worse, because as the relationship issues deteriorate, then it makes the fact that you're off of your life path worse and worse, and it just spirals. And so it's very critical and important for people to make a solemn commitment to discovering their life path and at least participating in it part-time. So if you have to start with participating after work or on the weekends, it's critical that you discover your reason and actually begin to participate in doing it.
So basically start somewhere.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And you'll probably feel better. And I think we've all been guilty of falling into, you know, old habits, or, you know, if you're in a job that you don't particularly like, or it's draining on you, you might stop at fast food restaurants, eat because you're on the go. And, you know, I think probably everybody in America has at least done that a few times in their life, you know, or more than a few times, you know. So, you know, and then you do those things, and of course it feeds to your depression. So absolutely. And then of course your energy level will go down with the depression. So
Interesting.
So thinking about that, because we're talking about life paths and spiritual paths, what do you think God's real plan is for your life? What is, you know, we talk about life path, you know, our life path, but, you know, what is God's plan for us?
Well, I think that people have a sacred contract. I think they create a lifetime that they are going to live out. And part of the struggle is to discover what it was and why it was that you came here for this particular lifetime. And it's different for everybody. And some people discover it at a very young age. People who become artists at a very young age and live their whole life being an artist. For me personally, it's always had something to do with being a help to other people, whether it's with counseling, you know, using therapeutic techniques, or if it's been helping people with their nutritional counseling so that their physical body can survive in some cases, and in many cases thrive. And so I'm very fortunate that for at least this part of my life, I feel very secure that I'm doing what I was put here to do by myself and God. And it's very helpful once you are in that place, because then it's easy to express gratitude for it each morning as you wake up, for the opportunity to be in a place where you can be helping other people continuously every single day. And then the more gratitude you express for that, the better it gets. And but sometimes people will discover something they think they are supposed to be doing, and then they'll get off track, and then they'll come back to it later in their life. Or they might find that they don't have only one life path, that they are destined to do a few different things. And that's perfectly okay too. People can live out part of what it is they need to learn or do or contribute when they're in their 20s and 30s. And it may be something much different as they get older. My sister, for example, was a school teacher until she got to be 60 years old. And then she retired and went back to school and became a personal trainer. So now she's helping people with their physical needs, and she's very patient and good with helping people with that.
It's funny you should talk about that. I'm going through assembly. I've been a corporate trainer for 20 years, and I think I've told you in personal chats, you know, I'm just like, I loved it. And now it's like, it's but I think, you know, that happens to a lot of people in their 40s, doesn't it? They start going, what am I, you know, they start looking at changes in their life. But I think that's kind of goes in hand with what we're talking about. How many people are going through, you know, like your sister, you get to this point in your life and you change, or there's something you're like, ooh, what do I want to do going forward? And, you know, I think they call those midlife crises if you're in your 40s. Well, I haven't bought a Corvette yet.
So see a lot of those around.
I bought a Mustang when I was 25. I think that was early enough. Well, so, you know, continuing on. So, of course, if somebody doesn't follow their path or they don't do anything, then they're experiencing a lack of energy. Probably wanting to just go home and crash in front of the television and, you know, suck.
Yep, that's true. And it's important for people to have some type of a routine in the morning, particularly, that can help them to access their their energy in every different part of their body, and also at every level of their spirit and mind and emotions, and to begin the day with a routine that will help you to get focused and strong and aware. And there are routines that can lead you into your higher self while you're doing your morning routine, so that as you go about your day, if you are on your life path, you are able to execute it with much more conscious awareness. And if you're not, it will allow you to begin to pay attention to what it is that you can do to begin to participate in your true life path. And there are some very specific things that people can do in the morning to help lead to that. And one of them is gratitude. So for most people, the best thing to do is when they first wake up in the morning, before they ever get out of bed, is to do an exercise in gratitude. And if you do it every day, you can express gratitude for things that occurred the day before. You can express gratitude for things you're anticipating that are going to happen today. And then what happens is you also develop patterns of things that you are always extremely grateful for, and you find yourself wanting to express gratitude for those things every day. And so each session will be a little different as you express gratitude for yesterday and today, and you express this overall gratitude. And quite often, that's the type of change that people need in order to get started. And then once your gratitude session is over, it's good to begin to feel your body and tend to your body. A lot of people neglect their body in the morning. They just kind of shuffle about and go through the motions until they can make their way to work. But when you first wake up, if you open up your place where you live so that light can come in, you begin to create a rhythm for your day that says, okay, the sunlight is coming up. It's time for me to stop with the melatonin, which is your master hormone of your sleeping state. You want that to diminish, and you want your body to begin to go into the rhythm of daytime. This is very important. It will actually help you sleep later on at night if you get light during the day, first thing in the morning especially, and if you can always go out at noontime on your lunch hour for a walk in the full sunlight, you will first you'll elevate your levels of vitamin D, your sunshine vitamin, but when it comes to be nighttime, it'll make it much easier to sleep, and that will give you more energy. Then the other things you can do is, as you get up, you should find a place in your home where you can do these exercises, where you have room to be either barefoot or in your stocking feet, so you can really feel your feet on the floor. And you want to begin your conscious awareness with noticing your feet and noticing how they feel on the floor, and also begin to bend your legs just a little bit. Move around, do a little bit of twisting so that you're limbered up, because the next thing that you might want to try is doing a technique that we call arm circles. And arm circles are a really, really beneficial exercise where you'll have your hands down by your side, and then you can move them together, touch them together like this, and then bring them all the way up over your head and make a circle, come back down around, and you're going to make full circles. And you do a circle, one circle on each breath. And that breath will be coming in through your nose on each circle, and you'll bring those around. Can you hang on just 1 second? I'm going to close my door because we got some noise.
Absolutely, that's fine.
Yep. All right. We had one of the people from my office was just leaving.
Oh, you're fine.
And she didn't know we were doing this. So So anyway, these arm circles are very beneficial because it gets you moving, but also what you will notice is that it's a signal to the universe, to the size of the blessings that you are able to accept on that day. And so as the universe witnesses this motion of your arms, and you have the intention that this is a signal for the blessings that you will be expressing gratitude for the next day, these arm circles are very helpful. So as you take in 3 or 4 breaths and you can't make any more circles, then you reverse the circle and make your hands go the opposite direction while you take one long, slow breath out through your mouth, and it goes, so your breath in goes, and the breath out is, and so the exercise goes 1, 2, 3, and then the opposite way. And you can repeat that 3 or 4 or 5 times as much as you can before your arms are tired. And this begins the day with an expression, a physical expression of the size of the blessings you are ready to receive. Very, very powerful bioenergetic exercise. And there's another one too, Jeremy, that is another demonstration to the universe about how far you are willing to reach and how flexible you are in accomplishing your goals and living your life path. And it is, the exercise is called picking grapes. And you can modify it in many different ways, but essentially what you're doing is with your hand, you're reaching up as high as you can into the air on your breath. So you take a breath in, and then you're pulling down your hand to back to level, and then you reach with the other hand. And you keep doing this exercise, reaching as high as you can, going up on your tiptoes, and it's showing yourself and it's showing the universe your capacity to reach for the stars. And this is a really, really great way to start the day, is with these physical exercises. And then another one that's really great is an exercise and a massage technique that you can do for yourself that's called lymph drainage. And manual lymphatic drainage can be learned also in a free video from our website. And it's a system where you can get all of your lymph flowing as if you had been on a rebounder, but you can do it with a sequential massage that will just get all of the lymph fluid in your body really, really flowing. And then as you finish doing these physical exercises, you then want to use, at that point, you want your morning nutrition. And we encourage people to use a kit that we have that's called a Youth Booster Pro Kit, because it has 4,000 different compounds in the kit combined, and it's comprehensive nutrition. And as you mix it up and get ready to drink the powders, which you put in a glass of water, and take your vitamin D, you want to be very conscious. A lot of people have many things on their mind in the morning, and when they are taking nourishment in the morning, they're not thinking about it. They're not appreciating it. They're not expressing gratitude for it. And what you are thinking when you eat has a tremendous effect on what is going to happen as a result of what you took in. And so you don't want to be watching TV, doing something that's distracting you. Your nutrition in the morning can make all the difference for the energy throughout the day, depending how consciously aware you are when you are taking in your nutrition.
So it sounds like there's quite a bit to think about here. We've talked about why, we have lack of energy. Now we're talking about, there's things mentally we can do. You do part-time, even if you have work, you can part-time do, meditation or, calming your mind and going into the no mind. There's even an exercise on your website that you were talking about earlier. And then we're also talking about exercises in the morning, which interestingly, they sound very much like the Qigong exercises I learned many years ago. but those are the bioenergetic that you were talking about. Mm-hmm. So, you know, there's quite a few things you can be doing. And then, of course, getting the proper nutrition in the morning, as you're suggesting. And, you know, just a reminder, you can go to those, get that kit at boomerboost.com. Which is Bob's website. So awesome. There's quite a few things for people to think about. And then we're talking about energy and vitality. I think the next thing is, you know, you talk about in the discussion we had before is how do you get to your A game and stay on it? So, you know, and I think that's the one thing that people struggle with. It's like they have great intentions then to get out there, and they maybe even have the energy to get there, but stamina. They lack the stamina to get there.
How to get the best out of yourself and be your very best is not something that's optional anymore. There's many different responsibilities and challenges that occur on a daily basis. And if you're not performing at a high level, you're in this day and age of globalization and extreme competition, you're probably going to get left behind. And so in order to really be on your A game, first you have to know what it is that you want and why you want it. So it goes back to what we talked about before with knowing your life path, so that as you get up in the morning and you finish your physical routine and take in your nutrition, you need to have some of your tasks set for the day. And those tasks need to be related to what it is that is going to really make you happy. So a really great exercise in the morning is one where you can ask yourself, if at the end of my life, I was making an assessment of myself and saying, was I really happy during my life? And if I was, what are the main things that I would have done almost every day to make me happy? And it's very good to have a list of, say, three things that you know are part of what makes you happy. And so as you have that list and you make that list, and you can do it after doing your mind-calming exercise, you then, at the end of the day, as you wind down and you find yourself back home, you want to then ask yourself as a review, what did I do today? And did I do any of those three things that are the things that I know that I would want to have done if I was looking back at my life on the last few days of my life? What would I, those things that I would have said, did I actually do any of those things today? And that's quite often a big question, because for the most part, if you're not living your life path, you probably didn't. But if you can get into the habit of asking, then you raise your awareness to the point where you begin to do those things each day. And maybe it's as simple as, I really wish that I read more books. A lot of people, that's something that they really enjoy, but they never find enough time to actually do it. So energy is a thing where people will, quite often you'll hear them say, Jeremy, well, I don't have enough energy. But a very good reframe from that is, how can I create more energy? Because energy is everywhere and everybody can have it, but you need to manifest it for yourself. You need to create it purposefully by recognizing what the things are that can rob you of energy, getting focused on your life path, and purposefully saying, I am going to create energy. So here's another exercise that people can do, and it's a way of creating energy with your mind. And then I'll talk about how you can create energy with your higher self. So creating energy with your mind is, you can do a quick gauge. You can say, okay, on a scale of 1 to 10, right this minute, how much energy am I feeling? Right? And then you can do this technique, which some people call the football technique. The football technique is, you imagine that your brain has left your skull and is floating out in front of you, and it kind of looks like a football, because most people don't really want to look at a brain. So you change it to a football and imagine that your brain is a football. And you are looking at it out in front of you, off to the left a little ways, and maybe 2 feet out. And just notice how you can manipulate it. You can make it tip up and down like this, push it farther away. You can let it come at you. And you also can then notice its relative level of energy. And as you look at it, you'll notice if there is an aura around it that is has a particular color, or if it's sparkling. And you can then purposefully change it. So you can say, all right, I want more white light around my brain that I'm looking at. And I want sparkly lights in there. And whatever your imagination can create to put this together, the reason you're doing it is you're then going to bring it back into your skull visually and, you know, metaphorically. And then as you do that, you're going to notice and say, all right, so what's my energy level now? And notice if it's gone up. And you can move it back out again if you want. You can put properties into it of gratitude and enthusiasm, and then bring it back into your head. And this is a way of manipulating your own mind to have more energy. And then again, this is a really great one, Jeremy. It's when you do this ultimate mind calming exercise, which we talked about before, and we also call it head circles, where you're moving your head in a circle and getting out of your mind and into your heart. You can then ask questions from that place of silence. And one of the very first questions that I would ask is, first off, is, who is it that's doing these head circles? And then sit quietly and listen, because that's when your higher self will begin to present itself to your awareness. And then as you've accessed this higher place, you can then say, what is it that I need to do today in order to create more energy? And then you're going to listen carefully to what your higher self is saying. And you'll be really surprised at the types of information that will come in. A lot of it relates to your life path. Some will relate to your nutrition. A lot of it's to exercise. People will procrastinate about exercise. And so you have to really be able to have the capability to be in control of your mind and your spirit in order to execute the things that you know you really should be doing.
Well, very cool. It's a lot of information that it's good information. I really think that the listeners and for those that watch the show for a while, I've talked on a bunch on spirituality and meditation, quantum physics and everything else, but we never really touched on the overall health of, not only the physical, but, the emotional. We touched on the emotion, but mainly on the spiritual aspects of the show. I think this is a good direction to go in and very helpful. The last thing I want to ask you is, what are the new advancements in nutrition science and health energy? I know we talked about your products a little bit in the beginning, but can talk about.
Yeah, absolutely. There's so many of them that I'll touch on a few of the most important ones, but one of the biggest advancements has come from scientists up in Canada that have figured out a way to amplify the quality and the potency of food by a factor of many hundreds. So they figured out a way to take seeds and make them sprout all at the same time. So they can have a million seeds in a processing plant and they have a technology where within 2 minutes of each other, all of the seeds will sprout. And which is very important because then the seeds will go through their metamorphosis toward becoming a blade of grass, if that's what it's for. They'll go through it all together. So you don't have some seeds that sprouted yesterday, some sprouted today, some are going to sprout tomorrow. And then the enzyme profile would be all over the place and the nutrient quality. So this is a very big breakthrough. And then the same people are able to analyze the nutrient capacity in the varying degrees of the sprout. And right when it's at its peak of nutrition, they can stop the sprouts from sprouting, which is very important because sprouts will just keep going if you don't harvest them and consume them. They'll just keep going and become a blade of grass, in our case, barley grass. So being able to stop the sprouts allows you then to let them dry for a couple of days, and then you can grind them up into a fine powder. And so now, for the first time, you can get a canister of pure organic sprouted barley seeds that you can actually mix in a glass of water. And Jeremy, these sprouted seeds are so potent that you can't use a full dose of them at the beginning. You can only take a half a teaspoon in a glass of water once a day for the whole first week. And then afterwards, you can increase slowly to a teaspoon, and then a week later, 2 teaspoons. And eventually, you can take 4 or 5 teaspoons in a glass of water. But there's such a large amount of enzymes and also superoxide dismutase, which is the main antioxidant in your body and the holy grail of anti-aging. There's so much of it in there that it's going to detoxify your body very strongly. And you don't want to detoxify too fast because your liver and your kidneys won't be able to keep up, and you could do more harm than good if you don't follow the instructions on this canister. But what happens when people take these sprouted barley seeds is it slows down their rate of aging, because when people are 20 years old, they don't age very fast at all. They just age along, and by the time they're 25, they don't really look much older. But if you know somebody who's 60 years old and you don't see them for 5 years, quite often you say, wow, that person really aged a lot. They're really getting old. Well, they actually are. They're aging faster as they get older. And the reason is your body is, it's like a log in a fire, and it's burning up slowly over time. We are aerobic life. And there is a main compound that's burning us up. It's called superoxide. It's 2 oxygen molecules together. It's very volatile and combines with our tissue. But we make an enzyme when we're young called superoxide dismutase, and it's like a Pac-Man molecule that consumes these little superoxide devils and makes it so you age slowly. But the older you get, the less you make of this SOD Pac-Man molecule, and so the superoxide ages you faster and faster. And the sprouted barley seeds have superoxide dismutase in it, which has been stabilized. And that's very important because SOD has a half-life of 10 minutes. And if you try to buy SOD from a company that hasn't stabilized it, by the time it arrives at your house, there's none left in it. It's long since deteriorated. But the same scientists that have these technologies for sprouting seeds also figured out how to stabilize SOD for a 2-year period. And that's why it's so important to take it according to the instructions. It is the holy grail of anti-aging, and it does work very, very well. But always it works very well, but you have to be careful to take it at the right dose. It's very, very helpful, Jeremy, for people with diabetes, because people with diabetes have way more superoxide than people who don't have diabetes. And the reason is in their bloodstream, as they have high blood sugar, that high blood sugar that is not utilized, that's not dropped down into the cell for energy, it bumps up against proteins and it glycates these proteins into a toxin, and in the process throws off a molecule of superoxide. So the higher your blood sugar, the faster you age. But even people that have severe diabetes, there's enough SOD in the sprouted barley where you can totally mitigate the negative effects of diabetes and the progression or the progressive dispossession that people with diabetes experience, where their kidneys and their eyes and their feet and hands begin to have a lack of circulation because of this superoxide. And so people with diabetes can have a very high A1C, the measure of their blood sugar, but if they use the barley product, they don't get the negative side effects. So it's very, very helpful. It's also very helpful for people who are going through cancer treatments, chemotherapy and radiation. They tend to lose weight very rapidly, and they die from muscle wasting before they ever die from cancer. And the sprouted barley seeds are so nutritious that they make it so that the people do not end up dying from muscle wasting, and they can continue on with all of their treatment and actually recover from cancer. And that's the one product that has made possible many other things in the world of nutrition. Another product we have is called Boomer Boost, and it has 70 different nutrients in it, which are the basic building blocks of human life. And normally it would cost a great deal of money, perhaps $1,000 for a month's supply to be able to get enough into your body to have an efficacious effect. But because of the SOD that's in the barley, it'll actually cleanse your intestine, Jeremy, so that those villi I was talking about before that get coated over, they actually get cleansed of that plaque and they regrow. They're made from glucosamine and they'll regrow so you can absorb nutrients like you were 20 years old again. And then when you take a product that normally would be very expensive to have this many compounds in it, like Boomer Boost, because of the absorption increase, you can put less of the content in and still get an even better effect. And those are two of the products that we have that are powders that we put in what's called our Youth Booster Pro Kit. And the other powder is a powdered probiotic, which is equally important because your body is actually only about 1/10 human and the other 90% is bacteria. And you want it to be the good stuff. And that's why you need a good probiotic. And in that kit, you also have extra vitamin D3 because people need to customize their D3. Maybe you're in the sun all the time in Florida. You don't need much vitamin D3. Or you live in Alaska and you need 10,000 IUs a day. So we needed to let people customize it. And then also in the kit is fatty acids. Fatty acids tend to make powders taste bad. So we did people a favor and we put them off on the side. And you now have a Youth Booster kit, which is comprehensive nutrition for the day. You only need to take it once a day, usually in the morning, because it does give you tremendous energy. It begins to de-age your body and give you energy all throughout the day. It's not like a coffee high. It's a steady, strong energy that lasts all throughout the day. And that we put those all together in one kit so that people could afford it. Because if you tried to buy all of these compounds separately, first off, you'd have 100 bottles of vitamin pills on top of your refrigerator you'd never be able to take. And it would cost many, many hundreds of dollars. And so we commissioned formulators to put these together for us in just the right way, in just the right ratios. And then we send them to people in a kit with instructions on how to use it, and eliminates all their other nutritional products so they don't have to hassle with them. And it also helps people eat a lot less food. And quite often people will eat 1/3 to 1/2 as much food, and the money they save on their food and on their other nutritional products makes it so that they can pay for their Youth Booster kit from the savings from the other things. And That's one of the specialty kits that we have at Boomers Forever Young.
Nice. Well, Bob, we've talked a lot of stuff, and I can't even believe we've been here but about an hour now. So we're doing pretty good. So we're going to be doing this as a series. I've asked Bob if we could do maybe once a month a series on health and nutrition and subjects like that. So I'm sure that you as the listeners or the viewers will really enjoy that. And You know, if there's a subject that we don't talk about, please, you know, send me a message. You guys know how to get a hold of me through Facebook or social media or through my email and stuff like that. Wanted to just reach out one more last time that their website is www.boomerboost.com. If you go onto their website to order, you use the promotion code SOULTALK or call into 800-861-4609 and use the same promotion code as well. Bob, was there anything else that you want to talk about really quick before we end the show?
I think that on the topic of energy, it's people don't have to accept the status quo. People are searching for more energy and they'll drink, you know, 5-hour energy shots or a lot of coffee and like that. And you don't really want to be doing that. You don't want to have this jolt of energy that's constricting your blood vessels and making your heart pump faster. Ultimately, it's not good for you. What you want to do is gain the knowledge and gain access to the companies that have the cutting edge products that can completely regenerate and revivitize your body so you have the energy of a 20-year-old again. Because as you do, as you take the right nutrition and you start to feel better, you start to bounce out of bed like when you were young again, then your attitude changes. And anything that might have been holding you back because of your low energy will shift. Your friends will start to notice that there's a shift in you. It'll make it easier for you to have energy to work on your true life path after you leave your job and eventually morph into doing your life path as your job. And this strategy allows you to create the paradise of your own choosing here on Earth. The paradise is here on Earth. It's where we live. Paradise is where we live. And so why not manipulate it and change it and make it your paradise that you choose to live in? And this is the opportunity that's afforded to people that can take control of their energy, create their energy, create their spiritual energy, create their emotional energy, their physical energy. They are then capable of becoming a being that is constantly creating the paradise of their own choosing.
Perfect. Thank you, everybody, for watching the Positive Talk Hour. Thank you, Bob, for coming on the show. I really do appreciate it. That's been very much a benefit and very much a blessing to have you on the show and to meet you and get to know you over the time. So, until the next show, everybody, and thank you, and have an amazing week and an amazing month. Bye-bye.